Hey everyone, I'm Andre with Cybergeeks, where we empower internet users around the world to protect your privacy, safety, and access to free and fair information by using a VPN. If you use a PC, chances are you're someone who loves having a little more control over your operating system, being able to customize your settings to be perfectly tailored to your preferences. But as you may know, PCs are also easier to hack, so you could find yourself suddenly very out of control. So you should definitely be using a virtual private network, better known as a VPN. For a more comprehensive list of why you should use a VPN, you can check out our 10 Reasons to Use a VPN right here. Today we'll be going over three of the top VPNs for PCs, as well as share with you which one is our top recommendation overall. Obviously, PC just stands for personal computer, meaning the best VPNs for PCs will work great with both Linux and Windows operating systems. With that, let's dive on in. NordVPN. I love to just cut to the chase, so we'll start with our top pick for the best overall VPN for PC, which is NordVPN. But of course, stick around to see if it has what you need personally, because it doesn't have absolutely everything, and if one of the other two might be a better fit for you. So, the lovely Nord. Nord has pretty much been established across the board as the VPN with the best performance and the best value out there for good reason. Let's start with their famous NordLynx protocol. In 2020, Nord released their own WireGuard-based protocol called NordLynx. They promised it to be the most significant technological improvement ever introduced to our customers and a VPN industry, and went on to prove it with some serious testing and third-party audits. They ran over 200,000 speed tests, and Nord consistently proved itself to provide the fastest VPN connections, even faster than other industry standards, like OpenVPN and IKE version 2. This matches up with our own tests, and we've even had some of our friends in other countries around the world run speed tests. And NordLynx consistently comes in first, or sometimes second, just depending on things like where you live, your ISP, and so forth. But Nord without a doubt crushes it on speed. This is a huge factor for someone who wants to stream shows, or movies, game, or even just realistically incorporate a VPN into your daily life. Because if your VPN slows you down, chances are you'll eventually get frustrated and turn it off, which completely defeats the purpose of getting one in the first place. And speaking of gaming, one of the biggest reasons why serious gamers love Nord is because of its speed advantage. Everyone knows that latency and ping are the biggest enemies of gaming. I mean, it can literally be a matter of life and death. So you can't have your VPN slowing you down at all. And fun fact, a great VPN can actually improve your existing speeds by preventing your ISP or internet service provider from throttling your connection speeds. Plus, by having a VPN with a large number of servers, you can connect to a server that is physically closer to your game server, minimizing even more the ping that you could experience while playing. So let's talk about number of servers. Nord has over 5,100 servers in about 60 countries all around the world, pretty much guaranteeing that you'll find a server in any location you could ever need. For some context, Nord ranks about third in terms of number of servers available from premium VPN services. So enough to give most people more than what you'd ever want without being overkill. This VPN also comes with killer features like VPN chaining or double VPN, which encrypts your data twice, an automatic kill switch that protects you even if you accidentally lose a connection to a VPN server, and split tunneling, which lets you choose to use your VPN for certain things and not others. So you could use it to protect your streaming, but not use it on your Google Maps, so you can still order tacos without having to physically type in that you're not actually in Antarctica. Nord also has a CyberSec feature which blocks ads and protects you from malware, which not all VPNs have, but all three on our list today do because we think it's important. And as for simultaneous connections, Nord lets you connect up to 6 devices at once, which is definitely more than I and most users need. But if you're someone who has a large household with lots of devices all being used at the same time, or you want to host big gaming parties where everyone can connect to your VPN at once, keep watching for our other recommendations. Moving on to the user interface, Nord has a pretty clean, nice-looking experience here. I like that they give you opportunities to customize while not being too overcrowded like some others can be. So it's kind of in the middle, not as clean as something like Surfshark, but not as busy as PIA, for example. Another cool feature is that they offer dedicated IPs as an add-on, which means that you can get a personal IP address that isn't shared with users. You have it all to yourself. Nord is located in Panama, which is the only VPN on our list today that is not part of the Five Eyes Alliance, an organization that tracks users' data for government security purposes. So if that's something you want to avoid, you'll want to go with a VPN that's located outside of the Five Eyes, and Nord is. One last thing to mention is that Nord has also been audited by third-party PricewaterhouseCoopers to confirm their no-logs policy. Pretty much every VPN out there swears by their no-logs policy, but unless they've been audited by a third party, there's just no guarantee. Unfortunately, there have been instances with other VPN companies where there was suddenly a data leak, and now, oopsie poopsie, your data was being stored and is now out there floating around. And we don't want that happening now, do we? So always check for that. And one thing that really stands out to me is the value you get with Nord. For being pretty much the most premium service out there, critically acclaimed by all the major tech blogs, including CNET, it's an incredible value to price ratio. I find that I get everything I need in a VPN with awesome speeds, security, and reliability, giving you a top quality service for less than $3.50 a month when you get the 2-year plan. So there are technically a couple others out there that are cheaper, but they don't offer you nearly the performance you're getting with Nord. So to me, it's kind of a no-brainer. And while Nord is already an awesome value, we were always looking out for the best deals for you guys. So we were able to get you an additional discount, and that's linked in the description box below. But now let's talk about two other great options that might have something else that you're looking for specifically. Private Internet Access, also known as PIA or PIA, depending on who you ask. PIA's main advantage is that it's 100% open source VPN, meaning that everyone, including you, can inspect its code and see how it works from the inside out. If you're the type of person that enjoys knowing exactly what they're getting, this point alone might sell PIA to you. However, this VPN offers much more than just being 100% open source. The most impressive thing about it is that it has, get this, 35,000 servers in over 75 countries all around the world. That's right, 35,000 servers. Kind of an absurdly large number, but also kind of awesome. For most of us, we don't need anything close to this number of servers. But if you're in the market for more servers than you could ever use in your lifetime and want to be able to find servers in tiny, obscure locations, PIA will be your best friend. PIA is also known for being super customizable, so if you're someone who wants to have maximum control over the protocol, you may like that. But I don't always recommend it for most people since it'd be kind of overwhelming. We find the user interface to be a bit gnarly to navigate, and for most purposes, these kinds of customizations just aren't necessary for most people. But if you're into that, PIA is great. Now, there are also certain customizations that can be pretty handy to lighter users like myself. For example, you can select certain networks you know you don't trust, like the library on campus, and the app will automatically turn on a VPN as soon as you connect to that network. There's also nice little notifications options, so you can choose whether you want your smartphone to vibrate once or send a notification after you connect to a VPN server. So that's fun. Features-wise, PIA also has that automatic kill switch and split tunneling, but no VPN chaining, so you don't get the double encryption that you get with Nord. PIA also allows a feature called port forwarding, which lets you access another device remotely. I personally don't use port forwarding anyway, since it can, by nature, be a more vulnerable connection. And again, if you're not an advanced user, probably don't need it. But if you do, PIA gives you that option. Protocol-wise, you can pick whether you want to use OpenVPN or WireGuard protocol when connecting to a VPN server. They also have a good ad and malware blocker called PIA Mace, so you're all set there. As for simultaneous connections, PIA lets you connect up to 10 devices at the same time, which, like I said earlier, can be useful if you live in a household with lots of devices, or you like to host gaming parties where a handful of your friends can all be protected under your VPN. So far, so good. But now coming back to what is a major drawback for some people. PIA is located in the United States, which is a part of the Five Eyes Alliance, an organization that tracks users' data for government security purposes. So if that's something you want to avoid, you'll definitely want to go with a VPN that's located outside of the Five Eyes. So with PIA, your data will never be 100% private, meaning the government can look at it if they want to. The US also recently made it illegal to bypass geo-restrictions, so if it's something that you specifically wanted to do with your VPN, PIA is not going to give you that. As for them not keeping any logs, PIA hasn't been officially audited, but they did get subpoenaed, and their no-logs policy was verified in two separate US court cases. So effectively, they've been proven to not store any of your data. And now for price. PIA is one of the cheapest options out there when you choose a monthly or longer term plan. So if that is important to you, that's something to consider. Windscribe. Windscribe offers one of the most complete products for PCs. Its main advantage is that it offers a selection of 6 different VPN protocols you can choose from, and a bonus feature that we'll get to in a minute. It includes popular and industry-tested protocols like WireGuard, IKE version 2, UDP, TCP, Stealth, and WS Tunnel, making Windscribe one of the best options for advanced users who know exactly what they want. It's also compatible with Windows and many Linux distributions, including Ubuntu, Debian, Fedora, and CentOS. A pretty big drawback of Windscribe, though, is that it only has like less than 500 servers, but with pretty decent coverage located in about 60 countries, which is much less than most of its competitors. Interestingly, Windscribe until recently was the only service on the market offering a server in Antarctica, but now Nord has one there too. So bragging rights, I guess? Windscribe is full of additional features like VPN chaining, which they call double hop, split tunneling, a feature that basically acts as a kill switch, protocol options for obfuscation, port forwarding, a good ad and malware blocker, but unfortunately don't give you a dedicated IP address. Probably because they only have a tiny amount of servers to go around. So you'll always be sharing a server with other users. Maybe not a big deal to some, but definitely worth mentioning. Windscribe is located in Canada, which is also part of the Five Eyes Alliance. So if that matters to you, keep it in mind. And unfortunately, they haven't undergone an official audit. So although they promise they're not storing any of your logs long-term, that has yet to be verified. So what about that big bonus feature? Unlike most other VPN providers, including the other two in our video today, Windscribe offers unlimited simultaneous connections. That means that you can protect as many devices as you want, all at the same time under just one account. If you're like me and only use a couple of devices at a time in your household, this doesn't matter at all. But if you're living in a large household with lots of devices, or you're a gamer who wants to have a bunch of your friends over and you want to use your VPN to enhance your gaming session, then it's a huge deal to have unlimited device connections. Pricing wise, you can choose an annual plan for only about $4 a month, which is a little higher than what you'd pay for Nord on the 2-year plan, but still pretty close, and you'd only be locked in for a year. Windscribe is also big on their freemium plan, which is of course limited, but is one of the only VPNs that offer a more robust-ish free plan, so you could always try it out first. All in all, Windscribe is a great option for PC if you're an experienced user who wants maximum control over which protocol you're using and unlimited device connections. But just know that you won't get that premium performance, speed, or number of servers that you get with a top-of-the-line product like Nord. In conclusion, our top overall recommendation for the best VPN for PC is definitely NordVPN. But it's really up to you and your personal needs. Remember to check out that link in the description box if you're interested in giving Nord a try. Hey, thanks so much for watching. Let me know if you have any questions in the comments below. We'd love to help you out in any way we can, and I'd be curious to hear what VPN you use and how you're liking it. So jump down there and let me know. If you find this video helpful, let me know by hitting that like button, and please consider subscribing to our channel where we share all sorts of useful information on all things VPNs and cybersecurity. I'm Andre, and until next time, stay safe, stay informed, and stay awesome. See you around.